Hi, I'm Diane Hoiser from PLR Planners, and in this video I'm going to show you how to convert a printable planner, such as this 5-year planner that I've got over here, into a digital planner using our PowerPoint Replicator software and Excel. Now, it is a little bit of a complicated process because you have to do some manipulation, but the first thing you're going to do simply is take your print planner that you want to now convert to a digital planner and open it in PowerPoint, and then simply go File, Save As, and change the fact to the file type to a JPEG, and then click on Save. And you want all slides. So we'll run through that and let it do its thing. And now it tells you it's been saved in a separate folder. So if I say OK and I go to my folders, you'll see now I've got a subdirectory called Original Print Planner. And if you open it up, you'll see there it's got slide 1, slide 2, slide 3, etc. Now that's great. So if you had to go Control A and then Control Shift to copy as path and put it in your Excel file, let me show you what happens. First of all, you can see over here it has brought it in a different order. So if I had to try and select that and then go to Data Sort and say I only want that section and tell it it's got that my data has headers and it's going to sort by image and say OK. Do you see what happens here? Slide 1 and then slide 10 and then slide 100. So that's not going to work. So I'm going to get rid of all of that. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to rename all of those files. Now, I can currently change file names in Bridge in Photoshop. You need to find some sort of software, and I'll try and I've been looking for some software, and I'll put some links down at the bottom that will enable you to do it. But the really important part is I now need to change all of these files from slide 1 to slide 001. As an example, depending on how many pages I've got in here. And since I've got more than 100, that's not going to work. So I need to do all of them. So I'm just going to go Control A and then go to Tools, Batch Rename. And my batch renaming tool looks like this. So I'm going to call it Slide. I'm going to make it a start at number 1 and it's going to have 3 digits. Okay. And it will now go through and rename all of those files for me. And that is step 1, because that's really important. If you don't get that right, this is just not going to work in terms of the Excel file. Now, the next step is obviously is the first slide we are not going to import, because that is going to be the first page on the right-hand side, which is effectively your title page. So I'm just going to delete that. And then I'm going to select all of these files, and I'm going to go Shift, copy as path and open my Excel file and drop it in there. Okay. Now, again, it's not sorted properly, so I'm going to select the column and I'm going to go to Data. I'm going to continue with the current selection and I'm going to have a header row and I'm going to sort from A to Z. So now you'll see it's got slide 2, slide 3, slide 4, slide 5, and the sequence is now correct. So that's the first step. Once you've got that right, we now have to manipulate this whole section into left and right pages. So I've set up a couple of formulas, which I'm now going to unhide, and I'll take you through the formulas step by step. So the first thing I want to know is, where does this number start? Okay, so I put in a formula, which let me just go to formulas insert function. And you'll see that I've told it to find a zero within the text, that line over there. And I'm not telling it to start at any number. I want to know what is the starting number of that first zero. So I'll click on it. My numbers start at 85. So the next thing I've got in here is I've got a function, if I insert function, I've told it to go and find the mid. So the mid is going to tell me, if I give it a starting number, it's going to give me a string position and length. So I've already worked out that my numbers start at 85. So I wanted to search within that text over there. My starting number, we've already identified as over there, is 85. So we're going to say 85. And I wanted to return 3 characters. Now you can see my result over here is 002, which is exactly what I want. So I'm going to say OK. Now, I'm just going to copy that all the way down to the bottom. And all you do is you just move your mouse until it becomes a plus sign and you double click. There are all my page numbers, okay? And we can see that they're running in sequence correctly. So I go in and I insert a function called isEven, isEven. So then I'll say, is that number over there, C2, even or not? If it's even, it'll return a true. If it's false, it will return a false. So let's have a look at it. So again, I'll just copy and paste it down by doing that. So 002 is an even number. 003 is not an even number. So that is the correct answer. So we can check that. Now, it may seem a bit of a complicated way, but this is the only way I could figure out how to get the left and right pages, because remembering that a digital planner looks like this, where you've got a left and a right page. So that's why I've done that this way. Now we go back here, and over here I've wanted to now say which is the left page and which is the right page. So I'm going to insert function. If D2 is true, then it's the left page. And we'll say okay. Then I went to the right page and I've used exactly the same formula and I've said if D2 is true, because remember I'm now on a different column, then I want you to return the line just beneath it. So even though we're on this line over here, which is line 2, I'm telling it to return the slide on the next line. If D2 is true, then I want it to return A3, which is the next one down. So now what happens is I've got left page, which is that one, and right page, which is the one beneath it. So now don't worry, we're going to get there. So now the next step is to copy that, to highlight those two, and double click the plus sign so it drives all of them down to the bottom of the spreadsheet. And now we're sitting with lines in between. So the next step is, now that I'm happy with that, I'm going to just simply copy those two, right click, and copy. And then I'm going to go and open up a new file, blank file, paste options, values. Okay, so now look what's happened. I've now got a left page and a right page, and then a blank line. So the next step is simply just to sort these two columns. So I'll just select them both. I'll go to data and I'll go to sort. And I have a header row and I'll just sort by the left page. Okay. Now it lines it all up and let's check our numbering. 2, 4, 6, 8. It's retained the numbering correctly. So there's 2, there's 3, there's 4, there's 5. And then you just scroll down to the bottom and you've got all those falses. So you just select that whole lot and delete the rows. Okay. So now my file is ready for me to import into the PowerPoint replicator. So I'm simply just going to file, save as. We'll leave it in that subdirectory and I'm going to call it Digital Planner Worksheet. All right. So it's ready. So now we can close all of that down. I'm just going to save that for future reference. And now what I've done is I've created a digital planner in PowerPoint. So the first thing I went and did is I went to do a slide master, and this is really important. I've created two slide masters. One is the front page, which we are not going to use for now, and then the second one is the normal page. And you would have seen that I've already put my tabs in. Now these tabs hyperlinks are not going to copy across. We will do the hyperlinks later once we've finished importing the document. But at least now, when you go back to view your normal page, your slide that you have selected, when you go to right click, layout, and I've said I want the digital double page, has got everything in you that you need. The next step is that with the PowerPoint replicator, you're going to go and insert a shape, and you would simply just go insert shape and you'd select the rectangle, and then you would drag it out to fit into that page. And I've made mine a different color, and I've also taken off the outline because if you leave the outline on when you bring in the pages that we've just saved, it will have a border around it. So, using the PowerPoint replicator tool coding, you would go percentage, left pad, percentage, and that has got to be in capital letters. And then you would copy it across to the right-hand page and you'd go percentage, right page, percentage. Now, if you look at my Excel spreadsheet, and we called it Digital Planner Worksheet, you will see that I've got here left page, no spaces, right page. And these don't have to be capital letters either. It could just be left page and right page. But the field names are identical to what I've got in my Digital Planner Master File Book. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this slide. And I'm simply going to have it as that. And I'm going to save it and close it down. And now I'm going to run the replicator and show you how easy it is. So in our PowerPoint replicator, we've got two options, the calendar creator and the PowerPoint replicator. I'm going to go to the PowerPoint replicator and I'm going to go to the actual replicator itself. I'm not going to create a template. We've already done that. So I'm going to go PowerPoint replicator. And the first thing it's going to ask me is select the PowerPoint file. So I'm going to browse. And it is our Digital Planner Master. Then it's going to ask me for the Excel file, and that is going to be our Digital Planner worksheet that we've just done. We'll click on Open. And then we're going to click on Verify. And it will run through and it'll check both the Excel file and the PowerPoint file to make sure that the field names actually match. Okay, verification is finished. Please check the results before starting the next step. So we do that. And it'll go through and it'll check the columns. And now you can see that in my columns found left page and right page is identical to the variables found left page and right page. So now I can close that down and I can just simply tell it to replicate. And it will run through and create the document for you. And as you can see, it's running down on the left-hand side of my PowerPoint file here and creating all of the slides. Right, so now it tells me that the replication is finished. So I'm going to close that down and minimize it. And I'm going to go back to my file. And over here, you'll now see there's a file called Digital Planner Master File Replicate. So if you open that up, the first page is kept as the coding page. And then you'll see that there are the JPEGs as I had saved them. So the only problem with this is you cannot edit this because it's now brought it in as a complete JPEG. However, you can edit the original document before you export it. So you could go and make any changes in here. Let's say you wanted to change the fonts or whatever, and then export it. But in this case, now we've now brought it in as a complete journal, and you'll see that it has created the planner with the left and right, and it runs sequentially. And I did this particular one on purpose because I wanted you to see that it runs sequentially based on the slide numbers. Okay, so there's 6th of January, 7th of January, 8th of January, 9th of January. And now you can go in and you can add monthly pages and do whatever else you want. And then right down at the bottom, you'd go in and you'd start doing your hyperlinking. All right. So that's it in a nutshell. If you've got any questions, please feel free to ask me. I am trying to find a way to automate this. All right, let me know if you've got any more questions. Have fun.